Hello everyone, welcome to the YouTube channel Mission Net Physics Exam. And guys, today in this video we are going to discuss a very important topic of mathematical physics, which is metrics. Now this video is going to be in the series that is Target 20, which is for the upcoming June 2020 CSIR Net Physics Exam. So guys, now let's start the discussion about this topic, metrics. And let me just tell you about the most important points which we are having in this topic, which we all should know if we are preparing for upcoming CSIR Net Physics exam or even for Gate Physics exam. So for both the exams or the similar kinds of exam, this is going to be a very important topic. Clear? Now let's just start the discussion and let me just tell you about all these important points. Also guys, before starting the discussion, I would like to tell you one more thing, that is, if you are new on this channel and if you have not subscribed the channel yet, then what you can do, you can subscribe the channel just by clicking on the subscribe button below this video, and after that you will get one bell icon there. Just click on that bell icon as well to get the notifications for all the new upcoming videos I will upload on this channel, that is Mission Net Physics Exam. Now let's start the discussion guys. So in the metrics topic, see, metrics is a topic which we all have studied in the 11th standard and the 12th standard, then in graduation, clear? So it's like a topic which we all are studying since a long time, clear? So in this case, what you can do, the basic part of this topic should also be clear to everyone. What is that basic? So guys, basics are like the different types of matrices, okay? And if there we are having a type, a particular type of matrix, and few conditions corresponding to that matrix, so the conditions should also be clear to us. Conditions like, if any matrix is an orthogonal matrix, then for that matrix A into A transpose will be equal to I, that is the identity matrix. Clear? Similarly, the conditions for unitary matrix, Hermitian matrix, Isquio-Hermitian matrix, symmetric matrix, clear? Idempotent matrix, or periodic matrix, involuntary matrix. So all these different types of matrices and their conditions should be clear to all of you. Clear? So that's going to be something basics. So if you will have enough time and you can go through the conditions once, the different types of matrices once, it will be very good guys. Also, in this, on this channel, like, I have uploaded one video about the different types of matrices, so which will be named related to matrix. Clear? And if you want to check that video, you can check the previous videos I have uploaded on this channel, that is Mission Net Physics Exam. You will also get different types of matrices and the discussion regarding them, okay, in that video. Now let's talk about the second important point which we all should know and we should prepare. So guys, now at this level, the type of question which we can expect in our upcoming exam, that can be related to eigenvalues. So we all should know about this thing, that how we can find the different matrix eigenvalues. First of all, you all should know that mainly we are going to talk about the square matrices here. So if any matrix is going to be a square matrix, clear? Then you can find its eigenvalue and what is the process for that? What are the steps we need to take for that situation? So guys, eigenvalue equation or the characteristic equation which we are having, which will help us to find the eigenvalues for any square matrix. Clear? What is that equation? The equation is determinant of m minus lambda I is equal to 0, where lambda is going to be eigenvalue symbol, okay? So the values which you will get for lambda, they are known as eigenvalues for this square matrix M. I is the identity matrix, that means only the principal diagonal elements of the I matrix will be equal to 1 and all other elements will be equal to 0. Depending on the order of this matrix M given to you, you will write the identity matrix corresponding to this M matrix given to you. Next guys, if I am going to talk about the second important thing, because see, at this level, the eigenvalues based questions are most expected ones, clear? So it is a very important thing, very important point, and the formula which you all should know. But corresponding to eigenvalues, there are many other conditions which we all should know. What are these conditions or tricks? So guys, let me just tell you some of the tricks initially. The tricks are like, if you are having any square matrix given to you for which all the elements are equal to 1, then in that case the eigenvalues of that matrix will be equal to the order of the matrix, comma 0, 0, 0. So depending on the order of the matrix, let's say I'm writing here a 3 by 3 ordered square matrix for which all the eigenvalues are equal to 1. Clear? So in this case, what will happen? If this is a matrix M, then its eigenvalues, that means lambda, how many eigenvalues will be there? 3. Clear? Because it's a 3 by 3 ordered matrix. But only one non-zero eigenvalue will be there, and that will be equal to the order of this matrix, which is 3 by 3. So 3, 0, 0. And rest two are going to be 0. Clear? Or even if it will be 4 by 4 order, and we will have all the elements of the matrix equal to 1, then it's going to be 4, 0, 0, 0. That means only one non-zero eigenvalue and others will be equal to 0. Clear? Next, one more trick, guys. That if you are having any square matrix given to you in such a way that if its rows and columns we can write as a scalar multiple of a particular row and a particular column, then you can write its eigenvalues directly. Now what I am doing to make this matrix, see, 1, 2, 3, 2 1s are 2, 2 2s are 4, 2 3s are 6. So I multiplied the first row with 2 and I am getting the second row. Then I'm multiplying the first row with 3 and I'm getting the third row. So it's going to be, but the same condition will also be applicable in the column. So 1, 2, 3. See, 2 1s are 2, 2 2s are 4, 2 3s are 6. Clear? Then 3 1s are 3, 3 2s are 6, 3 3s are 9. So it's applicable in columns as well as in rows. So in this kind of matrix, if you want to write the eigenvalues will be equal to the trace of the matrix, that is sum of principal diagonal elements, comma 0, comma 0. That means only one non-zero eigenvalue is there, which is equal to the trace of the matrix. And trace is 9 plus 4 plus 1, that's going to be 14, comma 0, comma 0. So these are the eigenvalues for this kind of matrix. But the rows and columns, you should be able to write both as a scalar multiple of a particular row and a particular column. So you have to check for both rows and columns. Clear? Next thing. Guys, if I'm going to talk about the next important point, that's going to be related to this thing that if you know a particular type of matrix given to you, clear? Let's say symmetric matrix, clear? Or Hermitian matrix, clear? So in this case, its eigenvalues will be purely real, okay? And for Hermitian or symmetric matrix, the eigenvalues will be either 0 or imaginary. Clear? Similarly, for orthogonal matrix or unitary matrix, eigenvalues will be of unit modulus. And next one, if I'm going to talk about the next one, that is nilpotent matrix, it's going to be 0. Clear? So for different types of matrices, we are having particular type of eigenvalues. And for that also, I have done the discussion in our previous videos. So if you have missed some of the videos on this channel, you can watch those videos. If you will check in the video section, you will get all these videos there. Clear? And I hope after watching that, you will get a complete list of matrices and their corresponding eigenvalues. Or even if you are going to prepare it on your own, you can go through all these points. They will be helpful for you to answer some of the questions directly in just few seconds. Clear? Next thing. Next important point. This is just a point I mentioned here, but you need to check this for all other different types of matrices. Okay, that video is available on this channel. If you want, you can check that video. Or if you want to prepare them like directly on your own, you can even do that. Next, guys, next is going to be the point that is related to rank of the matrix. If I'm going to talk about the rank, what is rank? Any square submatrix of any given matrix for which the determinant will be non-zero, that square submatrix will be the order of that square submatrix will be known as the rank of the matrix. So even if any matrix is a 3 by 3 order matrix and its determinant is non-zero, then you can say that the rank of that matrix is 3, because 3 by 3 order matrix is having a non-zero determinant. Clear? And let's say 3 by 3 order matrix is having a 0 determinant. Clear? Then you will check for 2 by 2 order. In that given matrix, if for 2 by 2 order matrix, the determinant will be non-zero, you will say that the rank of the matrix is 2. Clear? So non-zero determinant for any given matrix or its square submatrix tells you about the rank of the matrix. Clear? So that's how you can easily find the rank. Next important point, guys, that is the Cayley-Hamilton theorem. Now, what is this Cayley-Hamilton theorem? The Cayley-Hamilton theorem is that every square matrix satisfies its own characteristic equation or the eigenvalue equation. Now, what I mean by characteristic or the eigenvalue equation? So, let's say when I will simplify or solve this equation for any given square matrix M, I will get some equation or polynomial in terms of lambda. Clear? At the place of lambda, when you will put M, that's going to be as per the Cayley-Hamilton theorem, that is, the every square matrix will satisfy its own characteristic equation, and the characteristic equation or the eigenvalue equation is the equation which you will get after simplifying this part. Clear? So that's going to be the Cayley-Hamilton theorem, which is very important. Done? Next, if I'm going to talk about next very important point in this case, that's going to be if for any matrix N, eigenvalues are lambda 1, lambda 2, lambda 3, or so on 2. Clear? Then for m to the power 3, in the similar manner, as you will make the changes in the matrix M, you have just solved it or you have made it skew. Clear? In the same manner, the eigenvalues will also get changed, and that's how you will get the new eigenvalues for the new matrix in this form. So you can directly write them. Clear? Next thing, guys, if I'm going to talk about next important point, that is the trace of the matrix will be equal to the sum of principal diagonal elements. This is the principal diagonal. Clear? The trace of the matrix will be equal to the sum of principal diagonal elements, or even you can say the sum of eigenvalues. Clear? So trace equal to sum of principal diagonal elements as well as sum of eigenvalues. Determinant of any square matrix will be equal to the product of eigenvalues. So guys, these are very important points from the matrix portion which every student should know. Okay, and there are great chances that you can expect the questions based on these points in the matrix portion, or the questions which you will get related to matrix. In those questions, you have to use these concepts. Clear? So I hope that major portion or the most important portion of the matrix you have covered in this video. Clear? And from which there are great chances that you can expect the questions in the exam. Clear? So thank you very much everyone for watching this video till the end. Similarly, we are going to discuss many important things, many important points in our upcoming videos. So don't miss any of the videos. And if you are new on this channel, subscribe the channel, click on the bell icon to get the notifications for all the new upcoming videos I will upload on this channel, that is Mission Net Physics Exam. Also, guys, I would like to provide you one more very important information, that is related to Unacademy Plus courses and the Unacademy Plus subscription. I hope most of you are already familiar with the Unacademy Plus courses, that Unacademy Plus courses are going to help you to prepare for your upcoming exams very well, and with the help of or with the guidance of all the top educators we are having on Unacademy Plus for your exam preparation. So guys, if you want to take the Unacademy Plus subscription, you can take the Unacademy Plus subscription, and by using the referral code Anjali Arora, you will also get the 10% discount in the total Unacademy Plus subscription amount. Referral code is like Anjali Arora, but in that you need to write the first A in capital letters and all other alphabets in small and no space in between. Clear? So that's how you will write the referral code, you will apply it and get the 10% discount in the total Unacademy Plus subscription amount. Also guys, if I'm going to talk about rest of the things which are going to be, what are the steps to take the subscription, how courses will help you in your preparation. So once you will take the Unacademy Plus subscription, after that guys, for that much duration for which you will take the subscription, like 1 month, 3 months, 6 months, 1 year or 2 years, okay, for these durations subscription is available. Now, if I'm going to talk about the duration which will be best for you, that is like, so that take it in such a way that you will be able to attend the classes till your exam, or even as per, like, you know that, okay, this much time you need to give to your preparation, you want to attend the live classes for this much duration. Clear? So depending on that, you can take the subscription. Also guys, the steps are, initially download the Unacademy Learning app, log into the app, select your goal. Your goal will be CSIR or UGC NET if you are preparing for CSIR or NET Physics exam. After that guys, you need to do one thing, that is just click on the three lines you will have at the left hand side corner. After clicking on those three lines, you will get plus written there. Click on plus, then click on get subscription and get the subscription. Clear? And that's how you can also reach to that step where you will have to write the referral code. Okay, as I have told you, you will write the referral code there and apply it, okay, so that you will get the 10% discount in the total Unacademy Plus subscription amount at the same time. Done, so don't forget to apply it. So guys, I hope that each and everything is clear to all of you. And once when you will take the Unacademy Plus subscription, there are many benefits which you will get, like the weekly quizzes, doubt clearing sessions, mock tests, PDF of important notes will be available to you. Recordings of the live classes will be available to you. So all these things will surely help you to prepare very well for your exam. So guys, in this way, you can get most of the benefits by taking the Unacademy Plus subscription and get the best guidance by all the top educators and take your preparation to the next level. So thank you very much everyone for joining this session, for watching this session. So thank you. And if you are having any doubt at any point, you can comment below this video and let me know about it. We'll try to discuss those points. Thank you.